Now, we have known for more than 40 to 50 years that another area of impairment for children and teens with ADHD is in their relationships with other children. And you can see on this slide the numerous adverse consequences that occur within this realm of major life activity. So that by the time the child is in second or third grade, it's not unusual to find that at least half of these children have no close friends. And should the child also be very aggressive or have conduct problems, that number rises to as high as 70% or more of them have no close friends by the early elementary grades. And that's very sad because that's a significant social cost that will follow this child over time and may even increase their likelihood later on of drifting into affiliating with more deviant peers who themselves have also been rejected, may also increase the likelihood that they may experiment with illegal substances, and it may further increase the risk that they will engage in antisocial or aggressive behavior within the community. So there's a variety of consequences within the social domain that is linked to these peer relationship problems and that stems from unmanaged ADHD.